हेलो फ्रेंड्स, रिगार्डिंग द कंजेनिटल हर्निया देर आर ए फ्यू इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग दैट शुड बी कैप्ट इन आवर माइंड. सी, व्हाइल परफॉर्मिंग द वेरियस प्रोसीजर्स ऑन द कंजेनिटल हर्निया फॉर द ईयर्स ऑल टुगेदर, व्हाट आई हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट इन द स्मॉल चिल्ड्रन नॉट एंटायरली दीज ऑल inguinal hernia are congenital in nature. Majority of them or many of them are acquired in variety. So let us first discuss what exactly the congenital and what exactly the acquired variety. See, the hernia, as the definition go, is the protrusion of a viscus, any viscus, from an abnormal opening. So there is a protrusion of a viscus or a part of it through an abnormal opening is known as hernia. When we talk about the congenital hernia, one should keep in our mind an important thing that is known as processus vaginalis. Processus vaginalis. What is it? See, in the embryonic life or in the intrauterine life, the kidneys as well as the testis in the male baby, they resides in the pelvic region. As the maturity continues, the kidney ascends to fix in the lumbar region and the testicle, they are descended into the scrotal sac downwards. So in that way, somehow they just share the common blood supply. Now the testis, suppose if I just show it, there is an inguinal canal. In the small child, it is not, it is almost very short in length. So what happens that when testicles descends into the scrotum, they descends through a pouch of peritoneum. This is known as the processus vaginalis. Means the testicles, they are descended in the scrotum through a pouch, that is known as the processus vaginalis. In due course of time, this entire processus vaginalis is obliterated. So there is not any issue because this entire processus vaginalis is obliterated. But in some cases, this entire processus vaginalis or a part of it may not be obliterated. If this processus vaginalis is not obliterated, probably it may give rise to various conditions. Let us look upon that. Here, this is the scrotum. And the testis is descended into it. It is connected with the epididymis to the spermatic cord. The spermatic cord is a structure that contains the blood supply to the testicles, including the veins, that is known as pampiniform plexus, as well as the artery, arterial supply, and the vas deferens through which the sperm are carried from the testis to the seminal vesicles. So in this spermatic cord, now this is the normal anatomy. If the processus vaginalis is patent, then what happens that the contents of the abdomen, they may come out in the processus vaginalis to give rise to a condition that is known as the congenital hernia. The congenital word is used because it is caused by some congenital anomaly, means due to the non-obliteration of the processus vaginalis. So in that case, when we operate on these patients, we just see this processus vaginalis up to the continuous with the testicles. So we have to just divide it just prior to the, means in the vicinity of the testicles, and just evert means this process is finally continuous with the this tunica vaginalis. So somehow this is connected with the testicles, and while performing the operation we just separate it from the rest of the spermatic cord, and the cut end of this process as well, they are just everted, just like that we perform the case of a hydrocele. So this is a classical congenital hernia. But in some cases what happens that it is not entirely obliterated, but a part of it remains patent. Then what are the conditions that are caused by this processus vaginalis? If this processus vaginalis remains patent in the testicle area and obliterated in the inguinal region, then there may be a collection of fluid in the tunica, under the tunica vaginalis, and this leads to the formation of a hydrocele. But this is not a acquired hydrocele, means it is not caused by the hypersecretion of the tunica abulvulginea or tunica vaginalis surface, or by trauma, or by infection by any means, but it is caused by the patent processus vaginalis around the testicles, and this leads to the congenital hydrocele. So there is difference between the congenital and the acquired hydrocele, means that is caused later in the life and there is not any congenital anomaly. Sometimes what happens that the tunica vaginalis in this processus vaginalis around this area is obliterated. It is obliterated at the end of deep inguinal ring, but in between there is the patency of processus vaginalis, and what happens that a fluid is collected in this area, and this is known as the hydrocele of hernial sac. Means there is a collection of the fluid. So sometimes the pictures are somehow similar to the hernia without any descent of the omentum or other organs like intestines in this sac, but there is a collection of the fluid and that is obliterated from the both hands. So this is known as the hydrocele of the hernial sac, and a similar thing that is known as the encysted hydrocele of the cord. A small part of this processus vaginalis in a very small area becomes non-obliterated, means remains non-obliterated, and a small fluid collection in the form of a cyst is occurs over there, and this is known as the encysted, means this is a cystic collection, encysted hydrocele of cord. So there There are certain clinical conditions. We have to identify all these conditions, but if we see the operative procedures, then we have to operate on all of these clinical conditions in a similar manner. Sometimes what happens that the people the people have just diagnosed a case of hydrocele in the children, and just they operate this hydrocele in a normal way, just like the acquired hydrocele, but there is recurrence because the entire sac is not separated from that area. So in that conditions, I always emphasize on just operating these conditions from at near the pubic tubercle, means just a very small incision is needed. I have uploaded various several videos on these clinical conditions. I am just now mentioning the clinical conditions on in the sketch diagram, so that we could understand the different types of the pathology and different types of the diseases associated with the patency of the processus vaginalis. So now the my question is that I raised in the start of this video, that while operating in the children, I have seen that majority of these children's, they don't have such type of clinical features, means the processus vaginalis was entirely obliterated, but the hernia was seen to be as acquired nature as in case of the adults. So we have to think if there is any associated issue with these children. So in my opinion, while performing the operations on several children, I have observed that the congenital variety of the hernia just ranges between 60 to 70%, and the remaining 30% of the cases, they fall under the acquired variety. So in the acquired variety, obviously the procedure is a little bit different, because here the processus vaginalis is not connected with the scrotum, and in majority of the cases we just notice a sac inside this inguinal canal, and sometimes reaching up to the tip of the epididymis. Just we have to separate this sac as in case of the acquired hydrocele. So the point is that clinically it is a different issue. We have to think about why this acquired herniation occurred in such age of 3 years, 2 years, 3 years to 4 years, 6 to 7 years. It is a now a question of research. So we have published a paper in this regard, that I will give you the details in the link section. So my point of view is that while operating upon these patients in small children, we have to first work up regarding the clinical aspect of this condition, whether it is a congenital hernia, a congenital hydrocele, encysted hydrocele, hydrocele of the hernial sac, or omentocele, whatever. So first just work up on these patients and then go for the procedures. Thank you very much.